Blast off. Good start then from Andy Grant. Great launch also from Brad Sampson. Keep an eye out though in the background for the RS200 of Steve Harris, who's already up into second place by the first corner of Chessen's Drift. He's on the inside of Brad Sampson. Sampson's trying to hold it around the outside through the exit of the corner, but he's not going to have the momentum to hold it through there because Steve Harris's RS200 is an absolute weapon in a straight line, and he's through into second position. So it's Grant that leads the way from Harris once more. Those two going side by side up the top of the hill. Grant on the defensive, Harris on the attack as they come into the north bend. No opportunity presenting itself there for Harris to find his way through, but can he use the momentum of that RS200 to invent something? No joker laps in these Group B four-wheel drive finals, to remind you, by the way. So they are going to have to do the overtaking on track, as we saw in the Super Retro final very briefly ago. Into Chessen's Drift we go then for the second time of asking, and it's Andy Grant with the advantage, but Steve Harris makes a bit of a mess of Chessen's Drift there, and that's cost him time.
Yeah, two Fords, a Focus and the RS200, couldn't be more different, but they've enjoyed great racing across the opening two rounds of the British Rallycross Championship. Andy Grant again, as he has done for you today, goes deep into the Devil's Elbow, which is the bend you really don't want to make a mistake at. All the run up the hill and that passing opportunity at the North Bend hairpin, Harris wasn't close enough to capitalise then, but Andy Grant does seem to have a bit of a weakness at the elbow.
So down in towards Paddon Bend we go. Grant has just pulled out a bit of an advantage. That's the thing, he's a little bit weaker going into the elbow there, but he's able to get such good drive coming out of the North Bend down Harry Hill that it doesn't allow an opportunity for Steve Harris to be able to attack. I'm keen to see how this is all going to play out. Brad Sampson, meanwhile, is doing a good job of holding on to third position in this race as it stands. And he's all out there on his own because the rest of the field, like Dominic Flitley and like Joe Booth, are nowhere near him to try and challenge all sorts of sideways through the Devil's Elbow for Steve Harris as he really tries to put the power down of that Ford RS200. Grant a little bit wide through the North Bend, but gathers it all up, uses the momentum, and Brad Sampson has stopped, sadly. So a potential podium has come to nothing for the number 65. That is a big, big shame for the youngster because he was driving so well this weekend, and sadly it has come to an end owing to a technical problem.
Yeah, gutting for Brad on his local circuit. The Folkestone teenager is Andy Grant onto the penultimate lap now. He's held off Steve Harris so far. Can he continue to do it over the remaining lap and a half? We've got yellow flags at the Devil's Elbow as they pass the stricken Mitsubishi, and Steve Harris seem to pay too much attention to the yellow flags there. Closes right up on the Ford Focus, and they're as close as ever through the North Bend hairpin.
They certainly are. Grant there really went very defensive indeed. I think Steve Harris was caught out on the brakes, kicks up a bit of grass on the outside as he makes a bit of a mess of the exit out of the North Bend. That ultimately cost him time, sadly, and it does mean that he's now got it all to do as we come on to the final lap then. So it's advantage Andy Grant. More daylight than ever between himself and Steve Harris, and all that Grant now needs to do behind the wheel of that number 45 is keep it on the straight and narrow, drive his lines, not worry about what's happening behind, and he will be the victor then of this final in the Group B and four-wheel drive category here today for round two at Lyddon Hill. And what a weekend it's been for Andy Grant as well. He has driven superlatively over the course of this weekend. And we should give a very big shout out as well to the man who is in third position now. He inherited it as a result of Brad Sampson's demise, sadly. But it is going to be Dominic Flitney who will finish in third place. But Andy Grant comes over the timing line to take the chequered flag in the Group B and four-wheel drive final here for round two of the Five Nations British Rallycross Championship.